Hi, I'm Dr. Andrew Borrell. I'm an associate professor with QAAFI and a team leader for grain crop physiology and modelling. It's about developing crops that are resilient to different stresses, things like drought and heat and cold, a range of different stresses. And the framework that we're using is looking at genetic and management solutions. Genetic solutions can include looking at traits that might allow a plant to be able to go better under drought conditions. So looking at water supply and demand, it can be looking at things like root architecture. And we combine that with different management solutions. For example, the time at which a farmer sows a crop, the density of the crop, the amount of nitrogen fertilizer that's applied, the amount of water that's in the soil when the farmer sows, a whole range of things like that. You can imagine there's lots of combinations of genetics and management solutions for a particular environment, and we are trying to optimize all of those combinations. Simulation modeling allows us to be able to look at these different combinations and to select the most favorable. We also use it for looking at climate forecasting or commodity forecasting and to work out how a crop is tracking over time in relation to the climate. So in plant breeding programs and in looking at trait development, you can take a 10-year period where you go for something hard and you need it to be well resourced and you need to have the continuity to be able to achieve those sort of outcomes. This research is primarily done for grain growers in Queensland, so the outcomes are for our farmers to help them to assess risk and to be able to grow crops better in highly variable environments. But the implications are much broader, so a lot of our projects work in other countries as well, where the benefits can be more broadly shared, whether that be sub-Saharan Africa or central western India or parts of Southeast Asia.